Hello everyone, thanks for joining my channel. Today's video is all about the things that we should be thankful for. I'm actually gonna start by saying thank you to all of you. Thank you for supporting me, watching my videos, subscribing, sharing with your friends, dialoguing with me, letting me know how well I'm doing or some of your ideas. All of that has been amazing. This journey on YouTube has been something in and of itself that I've been very thankful for. Not everyone has the resources or the time or any of that stuff to start on just a hobby. So I am so thankful that I have been able to do this. It's a lot of work, but it's very satisfying and gratifying work. So I love doing this. And I thank you guys for supporting me and helping me do this. I'm also very thankful for some non-superficial things. I might complain about some things. You might hear me complaining, making like self-deprecating jokes or remarks about some of these things. But all in all, I do get that there are some more serious things in this world that I could be afflicted with, or that I could be, or my situation could be worse. So I do want to take the time to let you know or share with you some of the things that I am grateful for. One being, I always complain or make remarks about my hair, about it being thin or about it being hard to manage or whatever it is that I'm saying about my hair. I will say point blank, straight up, I am very thankful for the hair that I do have. There are some people who have alopecia or who never had hair to begin with, or whatever the case may be, they're struggling way more than I am just because I have some knots, some kinks, or some thinning and breakage. Like, so not even close. So I am thankful for the locks that I do have. I am satisfied with the locks that I do have. I'm always trying to improve and preserve, but I am thankful for that. The other thing I make remarks about sometimes are about my tiger stripes. And those are my stretch marks, or sometimes I talk about the cellulite on my thighs. I have those as a result of being a mom. You know what I mean? I am so thankful for being able to be a mom. Not everyone is able to have children. Not everyone can afford to have children. I have a healthy, beautiful, intelligent son who's going to be a great man. So I am very, very thankful for that. So when I talk about my tiger stripes or my cellulite or whatever it is that are a result of my childbirth, I am saying that in jest. It's very superficial. We all have things that we kind of are hard on ourselves about that really are, you know, make no difference one way or another. And that's one of them. I don't want you to think that, you know, I'm complaining about first world problems, you know what I mean, and ungrateful for my life and the things that I have in them. So definitely I'm very thankful to have tiger stripes and cellulite. Because when I think about it, I think God knew what she was doing when she gave me cellulite and tiger stripes, because otherwise I'd be in these streets looking a mess. I would not wear much of anything ever. So it's probably a self-regulating thing, to be honest. Also, I'm just very thankful for just, you know, my health. I have mentioned to you on occasion that I haven't been feeling well and different things have been happening. I, in the last 2 years, have landed in the ER, the doctor's office, the dermatologist, the dentist, more times than I would like to admit. I'm there all the time. We are on buddy-buddy basis at all of these places. But the thing that I'm thankful for is the fact that, one, I have insurance that I've been able to pay for the stuff. And then the other thing is that nothing has been life-threatening. Like, thank goodness, nothing has been life-threatening. Uncomfortable, yes. No one ever wants to be ill, but not life-threatening, and I'm so thankful for that. Nothing debilitating, nothing that has altered my quality of life. So very, very thankful for that. Also, I am thankful for my job and the things that I am able to do and see and get as a result of having a job. So I do recognize that not everyone is in that situation. So I have on occasion complained that I'm tired or I work a lot or I'm just super, super busy. I wouldn't trade any of it. I love being super busy with work, super busy with family, because I'm glad I have one. Just, I love having these hobbies, side jobs, the things that I love to do, all keep me busy. And that's a great thing, because on the other end of that spectrum, being bored all day, not having anything to do, I've been there. Oh yes, I have stories. One of these days I'll share some of those stories with you. I have been all the way on the other spectrum, end of the spectrum, and have been beyond bored, and that's not a good place to be either. So I'm thankful for the life that I have and the fact that I'm busy and the fact that I have things to do and the fact that I'm able to do them. So I'm thankful for all those things. So with all the thankfulness out of the way, I do have some gripes. I have some honorable mention things that I am not grateful for, and I'm just going to go ahead and get right into that. This is more of a post-haul review, like my real thoughts on some things or what has happened with some of the things since we've spoken. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. The first thing I want to talk about is the natural deodorant that I recommended. Now, I still recommend it. This is the Schmidt's Rose and Vanilla. I still recommend this deodorant, but there is a gotcha, and there's a gotcha with everything. When you trade something in for something else, there's always pros and cons. Pro, smell great. Pro, it keeps me smelling great all day. Pro, it's natural, so therefore less, less of a chance for me to get like cancer from the aluminum and all that good stuff, or clogged pores from the antiperspirant properties. So, pros, right? Con, it's not an antiperspirant, so you sweat like a mother. And when you sweat like that, it gets on your clothes. And I feel like I am ruining a lot of my light t-shirts and white t-shirts much more quickly than I would have had I had an antiperspirant deodorant. So I guess it's a fair trade-off. Ruin a t-shirt, get cancer, but it's annoying. So I will say that you don't stay as dry, which I don't really care about. And then you do wreck lighter colored shirts. So that's the con. Those are the cons that I want to point out about these. I'm not loving that about it, but I'm loving everything else about it. The next thing I want to show is the Tango teaser. I showed you this a few weeks ago when I wasn't feeling well, so I'm not sure how well you were able to pay attention to the review with me wheezing and dying, but I did want to point out, I did try this a couple of times now. The first time I told you there was a lot to me, about the same amount of hair came out as when I use any other detangling method, a comb, my fingers, whatever. There's always some hair that comes out. This makes a god-awful sound when you brush it through your hair, but the thought is that it's not ripping your hair out like it sounds. But I've used this the first time and I thought, you know what, I think a good amount of hair came out because I'm trying to get to a baseline. It was very, very tangled. I had knots in there, blah, blah, blah. So I used it, got to what I call my baseline, used it again for my next wash day, and I had the same results. That sound, that ripping sound, and a lot, not a lot, but the same amount of hair came out. So I don't, and there's not any, to me, it wasn't necessarily any faster than any other method. It was just, it's just another way. The cons to it is that, like I said, it's not any better, but then also it's hard to hold. If you have any product or water, this is supposed to be ergonomic the way that it's designed, but it still slips. It just, they need to have like grippies or something on the side here so that it stays in your hand, but the surface is smooth all around, so it just slips right in and out of your hair. Like I'll be like getting through a really good tangle part and like whew, just lose this. And so that's the con of this. It's not any better than anything else, and it's hard to hold. So I'm not in love with the Tangle Teaser. The next thing I want to show you is what I thought was a great steal, a great find, a great buy, all that good stuff. It's this gray leather Timberland belt that I bought from the men's department at Nordstrom Rack. And I love the design of the belt. I love this like sort of antique looking buckle, this sort of worn gray leather. But the only con is the fact that the second time I wore this, this part broke. Literally the second time I wore this, the part that holds the belt broke. And I am so used to Timberland having like superior quality leathers and craftsmanship. It didn't even dawn on me that something like that could happen that soon with my product, but it did. So I am very annoyed by that. I'm sure I could, crazy glue this down or whatever, but that'll wear over time as well, just from me using it. So I'll have to keep crazy gluing it. I'm just annoyed by the whole thing that would even happen after the second time of wearing this. So I am complaining about this Timberland belt. I am not thankful for this belt. The last thing I want to talk about is I went to Anthropologie and I bought a few things, and there was a set where they had these hair ties, these satin hair ties, and then a satin head wrap for, you know, your hair at night. And it sort of ties and, you know, makes like a little scarf or like a little do-rag. Yeah, like a do-rag. So I had tried to use these when I made my last review. And I told you that these were so tight. I don't know whose hair they could fit on, but it's so, so tight. I imagine that maybe if you keep using them or keep pulling at them, they will stretch a little bit so that you could, you know, use it on more than just one, you know, one ponytail. But I just, you know, my recommendation was to not get these or not get the set at all, because these come with the set. At that time, I had not used the do-rag and I assumed it was fine just by looking at it. But look how little this thing is. Oh my gosh, I can't fit. And I have a pea-sized head. I have a little head. I don't know if that registers here on the screen, because I'm the only one in the screen, so my head probably looks normal. But I have a pea-sized head, and this thing does not fit around my entire head. I've worn it a couple times, you know, just, you know, out of spite, because I'm like, I bought this, I'm gonna wear it. And my hair falls out of it. Like, it does not hold your hair in, nothing. It's awful. This whole set is awful. So you got like three of these or something, like three or four of these, and then this do-rag. A waste. An entire waste of money. So I am not thankful for this do-rag hair tie set from Anthropologie. So that brings me to the end. I wanted to do just a small special segment for Thanksgiving, just to talk about the things that I'm thankful for and the things that I'm not so thankful for. And I hope you enjoyed that. Hope you enjoy the holidays with your family, with your friends, and even if it is just with yourself, sit back, take some time, and think about the things that you're grateful for. There's plenty. There are so many people who have less or are in worse situations. So try to think about those things. All right, thank you as usual for joining. Have a happy holiday. Bye.